$25 for the food and beer.
So we're in Český Těšín on the border of Poland and Czech Republic. So right now we're in the Czech Republic. We got food before our train ride to Prague. Just normal cutlet.
Going back to Prague like
first
Rambo.
Czech beer. It's 10 a.m. Yeah. Jake got a water because he...
I couldn't do it.
Yeah, he couldn't do it. The car ride was pretty bumpy because they have renovations on the road, so we had to go up the mountain.
Yeah, he was just four-by-fouring it all the way up that mountain.
We're here now. We're off to Prague in maybe an hour and a 40 minutes. Delayed 50 minutes, so we're gonna have to wait here. At least there's Wi-Fi, so it's nice. The toilet costed like 10 krona. I just told her I had złoty, so she said, okay, that's fine, 2 złoty. So I gave her 4, so I felt bad. But yeah, we missed Poland for a bit. Oh, now it says 60 minutes, so I don't know how long it's gonna take, but no biggie because we have nothing really to do today. We gotta start planning where we're gonna visit and do all that crap right now. So, yeah, platform 2. Hey. Biggie.
You want to know how much this beer costs you?
Yeah.
$80?
Yeah, sure.
Because I want to prove a point to you.
Okay, that's 30 cents less than
$2.
All right, cheers. Cheers to $2.29. Yeah.
That's really good.
Okay, if it's with the beers, can we just go to a pub and just drink? Well, what do
you think I'd have planned? I'd be down to get a hammer one night here.
Can we just get a hammer tonight?
Let her know.
Yeah.
We got goose here. He's got duck. Brant's also got duck.
Oh, it's so good.
I already tasted it.
Have you guys had the bread yet?
Oh, the bread's amazing.
As well. You enjoy?
Thank you.
Okay.
Have you guys had this bread yet?
The bread's insane.
Okay, out of all this stuff, honestly, this is the best bread I've ever had in my entire life. Like, I'm not
I don't play me.
Like, this bread is actually fucked up. Like, I'm not even putting butter on this. Nothing. Mm-hmm. Like,
That's really good.
That's surprising me. I'm actually very surprised by the bread.
I never had a goose before, so.
You eating that goose all makes me think of this Matthias.
Yeah, I know.
Boys, try to have some goose.
Yeah, everything's good here. A little chip here.
Oh my god.
Wow.
No, you lost the game, Skip.
You lost the game. No, it's no, because the Grey Cup halftime show has never been iconic. It's so? Never been. So, playing the Grey Cup halftime show is not a big deal, okay?
Yeah, but playing the NFL the Super Bowl back
it
then.
It is huge.
It wasn't a big deal back then. No, it wasn't.
Hey, guys. Guys,
that's nearly as big.
Guys, guess what? You know what flag that is? Myanmar. Let's go.
Myanmar?
Okay, that's the most brand thing I've ever heard. Don't flip over a table.
You know, this is the first we've had, it's only because I know the NFL.
No, okay, this is about you having Brian Adams take it. Because you know for a fact that the weekend is at way more hits than Brian Adams.
I'm not even concerned about that at this point.
Yeah, this one's getting fun right here.
The NFL Super Bowl 50 years ago is better than the CFL Super Bowl.
Brian Adams is not 50 years ago.
What? Brian Adams is like mid-80s.
40.
Yeah, mid-80s.
That's 40 years ago.
That's 35.
That's 10 years out.
That's 40. Jake, that's 40.
That's 36 years ago. And okay, so 36 years ago, the Packers had already won like four Super Bowls. The 49ers, Joe Montana, were in their prime. I don't know, man. This is the 80s we're talking about, not the freaking 70s. The NFL was big time in the 80s. Joe Montana, Joe Namath
is the CFL.
Joe Namath,
Michael Vick.
Basically
Vick.
The same size as the CFL.
I don't know,
man. I don't know if you realize how big the gap spread from the East to
the other day.
No.
This is the this is a shopping square. On the right leads you to the gate, and the left is
some of them don't want
closer to the river.
The only ones who can make enough money to even play it luxuriously is people like Mike Riley.
Okay, we're going here when we get our stuff.
Yeah. Okay, let's go.
This
get
is
it.
Where we're starting our like whole thing today. Okay. We're gonna, but we're supposed to first go to the hotel.
But like, I've seen some guys with CFL real face. Like some whole line, D-line. Yeah. Even a couple linebackers running. It's all in Albania.
Look how nice it is though, for real though.
So this is actually so like, this is cool. This is like...
completely different.
Dzhabka! You've made it here, Tom.
It's literally, it is Dzhabka.
But it's got a different layout.
Well, it's spelled in their language.
And it's got a different logo.
Oh wow, that's a gothic, more balanced gothic.
It is very gothic.
Oh, it's really gothic.
It's built in 1380. And this isn't the main site. I'll show you what the main site is. So this is the astronomical clock. It was built in 1410. Every hour there's the walk of the apostles, and there's a sun and a moon on the dial here. Yeah, now I can see it. It has been running ever since the late 1500s. I believe it was broken for 100 years.
Yeah, it's pretty cool.
This is main square.
Short guys, yeah, I break the rules of the short guy thing. Oh, short guys usually
no,
hang out with short guys.
No, our theory is the
So this is the Church of the Mother of God before Tin. It's a Gothic church and a dominant feature of the old town of Prague. It has been the main church of the city since the 14th century. It's 80 meters tall and built. It was first built in 1380.
Now they're playing one of the worst teams in the
nation. Yeah. So they beat number one, I bet you they're right.
Okay, so at the end there, you can obviously see it's the Powder Tower. It's one of the original 13 city gates, actually, to the old town of Prague, and it separated the old town and the new town.
So this is the new town?
No, this is the old town, and once you cross there, you're in the new town. Yeah. It was built in 1475. It was a defensive tower. And,
Was it ever attacked?
The tower is inspired by the Charles Bridge one, which is built earlier, which we'll see tomorrow. Yeah, so 1475, but it was renovated in the late 1800s.
It looks nice, though.
That's why it looks a little bit new.
Yeah.
Prague's prime or heyday is the 1300s to the 1500s.
Okay, so like after.
During the Holy Roman Empire.
Yeah.
So that's not the Roman Empire, but it's like, it's basically a German wannabe.
Yeah.
Charles IV, the emperor, was in the castle that's behind this. Holy Roman Empire. It's very medieval.
What's the difference between the Roman Empire and the Holy Roman?
Holy Roman Empire is German. Roman Empire is Italian, but they were together. The Holy Roman Empire was consisted of Italy, Germany, part of France, and a little bit of Prussia.
Really? I just always assumed it was the same thing, just Germany. I didn't realize it was like a German, like sort of like the
it's
German.
It's huge. Versions. If you look at a map of Germany from the 1500s and actually look at the separate countries, they're all really small. They're the size of Chilliwack all over. And then the Holy Roman Empire combined it.
Huh.
But like it wasn't really combined at the same time because those like duchies or whatever, they were still had their own laws and that. And yeah. That, yeah. I don't know if you know about Charlemagne, but he was the emperor of the Holy Roman Empire.
He's big.
Yeah, I don't know. I don't know if it's the right Charlemagne.
Chilliwack just ain't gonna be the same.
Yeah, but Chilliwack has his own thing.
It does. I know. It's just.
Yeah, I agree. Yeah, yeah.
Go anywhere in Canada.
I don't know.
Where you get this vibe.
Yeah.
Sushi. We're not even close to the ocean, are we?
I don't think so.
No, we are definitely not.
Oh no, they are.
flight. Jake here. Six mystery beers. All of us are getting six. It's gonna be little, it's gonna be beer. Fun. Are we going ale first?
Ale first, please.
Ale's the best, man. Cheers.
So we just put in collection hours.
Yeah, which is actually shitty because the NEP is actually kind of good.
Perfect there.
They were
for VC.
You know what? NTP.
No, I said, I'm worried NDP is going to slip in federally because that would actually be bad.
But like,
this synagogue was built in 1592 on the basis of Emperor Rudolf II. And it was burnt down in a ghetto fire in 1689 and then re-restored in the late 1800s. So, we can go in. You see the Ten Commandments? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That's cool.
Wait, did you see it was burned down?
It was burned down in 1689, yeah, in the ghetto fire.
This is already considered the ghetto?
Yeah, we're in the ghetto area, yeah. But it's
1867. I thought the ghetto wasn't around until like...
No, in 1689.
1689?
Yeah.
I thought this wasn't considered... Like, I thought the ghetto wasn't around until...
So this is our second day in Prague. I was incredibly tired yesterday because I was planning 6 days of traveling and on the train. And now we're here. It's raining a bit. But it's not bad, it's warm. Barely need my hoodie on. We're just waiting for this synagogue to open at 10 here. Excited for the, we're gonna see Charles Bridge, St. Vitus Cathedral, and a lot of other stuff. It's gonna be really fun.
So this is the old new synagogue. It was first built in 1270. It's a Gothic style synagogue, and its affiliation is Orthodox Judaism. I believe the Spanish synagogue that we'll see next is Conservative Judaism. It's a little bit different. Synagogue is the newest synagogue in the era. It was built in 1868 as the Moorish Revival architecture. Its affiliation is Conservative Judaism.
Look, they have a bunch of music on here, so they have Jewish religious music. Here's all the songs, the different songs. So they got about four or five songs. The last song I played for Tom was sung by a rabbi, actually.
Yeah.
Then they have the general background music.
Singing the verses from the Old Testament.
Yeah. Then this part right here controls just the regular music. I got Tom listening to that right now. And then here we have some secular music, but there's only one song. So this is like later music. It's pretty cool though. And this stuff celebrates film, theater, architecture, literature, fine arts, even science. It's pretty cool.
Wow. How many Nobel Prizes did you have? It's like the most,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, it is. Well, I think even Albert Einstein was Jewish, yeah?
Yep. Thank you. You'll find this. It's the big sign. Really nice. I would take off the windbreaker because you can wear it all day.
Take off, yeah, until you tell me what to do.
Ooh. This is a kosher restaurant near the synagogues here. Ordered the hummus. Oh, there's Brant.
So I ordered the hummus here. With ground beef. That's really good. Wow. Finish the hummus here.
Jamie's signature is the NDP and the NDP. Almost every year.
No, it's a carrot soup,
almost
I think.
Almost every year, everybody really loves good. The NDP doing the best, but doesn't work for them. This is the NDP.
Thank you.
First of all, how did Brian get hit as fast as me?
Just because you had to
go. Oh, there it is. Up there, up there. It was the windows.
You're right.
That's cool. Every hour of every day for 600 years. Yeah! I like that. Where were the fireworks? What you just saw was the walk of the apostles. All 12 of them came out. Not that there wasn't any fireworks, but it was fun to see. Happens every hour of every day. Now we're going to the Church of Artin. Over there.
This.
I like it though. Jake, you want to get there? Jake, if you go there, I'll give you $30.
No, fuck.
I'm not even joking. $30 Canadian dollars. $30.
Okay, let me $30.
$30.
Let me take one out.
What are you gonna think about $30 for? Same goes to you. It's not that hard. Yeah. I'm holding the camera so I can go. Yeah, everyone's looking for the kid.
Yeah. I know.
Come on.
Oh, you have some strength, big fella.
Santo Domingo, uno dei primi santi martiri della città di Italia.
vibing for free. But
okay, so this is Charles Bridge. Construction started in 1357 under Charles the Fourth, soon to be Emperor, and it was finished in the early 15th century.
What was it on the other side of the river in the old days?
Prague Castle.
That on the top of the hill?
That's Prague Castle, the entire thing. It's similar to the Powder Tower. No rain, it's awesome. I don't know how to pronounce it, but it starts with a V, Vistilia or something. You have no idea how hard I hold the camera when I do that.
Pops out your hand
because
you squeeze it too hard.
Oh, don't give me that anxiety. That's why it's good to have this. Squishy.
No, you have a wristband.
It's for dumb people. That's for dumb people. Wow, it's incredible. So it's the biggest ancient castle in history, but I believe the biggest castle in the world is in Malbork, Poland. It was a Teutonic Knight castle.
Ooh.
Yeah, Teutonic Knights are really bad people. They were German. We're walking the steps here to get to the top of Prague Castle here. How are you feeling?
Feeling good.
Yeah? No, you said you weren't feeling good because of that burger, huh?
Oh yeah, no, that burger, yeah. Okay, I actually lied to you, so it's feeling good. The burger took some out of me.
Yeah. How are you feeling, Brent?
Pretty good.
Yeah. Brent and I had healthy food.
Yeah, I told you.
Made it. We're on Prague's castle. President lives there. Heading into St. Vitus Church now.
Not like mine.
Yours looks good though. It's not like it's like a...
No, I probably look super serious after
this. Yeah.
I'll talk to you
about it. Yeah? Yeah? Yeah. The remnants of the Church of the Virgin Mary from 1915. Pretty cool. All right, so tomorrow we go to Munich at 7:43 in the morning by train, another 4-hour train. So we'll get some good sleep and see Munich tomorrow morning. It's just outside the church here in Prague Castle. Can't beat this view. Pretty incredible Gothic church.
The outside of these Gothic ones are just so
very, very, very unique.
So much.
Well, we're gonna see a few more things. Probably up in the mountain nearby here, and maybe the Lenin Wall, and then we're gonna get some beers. And yeah, that'll be our trip in for Prague. Goodbye from Prague. Next stop, Munich.
Pushing you up, you know, it's very dynamic.
Yeah, it
dynamic.
Is.
Yeah,
it is, right?
Really there.
What's your name?
Tom. What's your name?
Tom.
Tom. Yeah.
Bertolt.
Bertolt.
Oh, okay.
Bertolt.
And Brent.
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 Swedish.
Brad. Yeah, Gabriel. Swedish. I can speak Swedish.
I can't
speak Swedish. Oh, he doesn't know.
I'm Canadian.
No.
I can't speak Swedish.
School?
School. Yeah, I missed out because I was speaking Russian for a few days, so now it's messing me up.
Yeah, Sukablet.
Sukablet.
Yeah. How do you feel?
Oh,
hey, cheers.
That actually saved me.
We're in a tavern right now. To our last day in Prague. It's our first and last. That's Pilsner Ukrel.
What?
Pilsner Ukrel, the most famous beer company on the planet.
No, this
one. Yeah, okay, thank you.
Yeah, he realized we were reading Goulash. He's like, fuck.
You got the Goulash, where you got the cheese
pie. I'm going to
take a photo. Goulash as well. That was really good.
Do you understand my English?
Yes.
I am the worst English speaker ever in medieval Prague, so if you understand me, you understand the city. Ladies and lovely gentlemen, let me welcome you here at the King of Preventian! What you will hear and what you will smell during this evening, we have a special 3D show. You can watch our beautiful belly dancer. You can listen to medieval music. This is Andrea, Andro folk singer from medieval times, and you will smell our salt fighters. Dirty guys who never used conditioner like you. So enjoy this evening, start drinking to be more spontaneous, and now we start with the first song. And important information for you, you can dance on the tables!
Oh,
There you go, yeah, there's the photo.
Wow. Is it a good photo without the flash, yeah?
Wow.
Wow. Oh my god. You got pussies. They don't have this in Canada, man. They're like this big in Canada.
But you see how big?
Yeah, that's
so cold.
Yeah, it's smooth. It's smooth, yeah.
I need a pair of boots.
Holy shit.
How can you like Tony Montana and you don't like
Coca-Cola? Because of Godzilla.
Right?
But everything
yeah.
is
you like it for yeah. ideas, not for cocaine.
Yeah, the world is yours. The world is yours.
And it's not connected? I got my bitches out in Georgia.
I'm there on stage.
This is a great.
We find.
They protect
me. We have a connection.
It's been in 12 Albanians.
You can make 3 days. 3 days, 2 Albanians, and 1 French lady.
Yeah, that's like a start of a joke.
Yeah, it is.
I call him.
This is a pretty good joke here.
Don't call him.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, I promise I got a second tool of my trade to show you. Please have a good look at my just a minute.
Which one?
Okay, I need one grain of the. Okay. Alright, first question. Do you play any musical instrument?
Yeah.
Which one?
Electronic.
A MacBook.
I can play the piano.
Or the piano. Okay, never mind. Do you do any martial arts? Any martial arts? Boxing?
Karate!
Karate? Excellent! So, please, come over here. Now we will reconstruct the medieval punishing situation, okay? And Bertold, okay. Bertold, please give me the basic guard from karate. Yeah, basic guard. No. Guard, just the guard, just the basic position. Excellent. You can relax your legs. You can, yeah, like this. Okay. Now, I will just slightly adjust your guard. Yes.
Merci.
Yes. Good.
Yeah, merci.
Spine straight. Okay. And now, Bertolt, you are officially Lord Zavecek. Zavecek, Rikla Zavecek. Rikla Zavecek. Česká sekce boží práce, Jakuba si porvědělá. I will say, 3-1, you give me the angry map situation, you know very good, and I will drag Bertolt all over the place to the city gate. The sharp deep is walking. You are a very energetic guy.
I'm very energetic.
You can find it okay.
He said, I need cocaine, that's what he said.
Just pretend.
Yeah, I will do. Don't break my neck.
Yes, don't break my pillory, okay? Ladies and gentlemen, my count. 3, 2, 1, now! Thank you.
the Czech.
Ladies and gentlemen, General Battle!
I think the best part was when he was like, "You were a very energetic guy."
Yeah, I need cocaine.
I need cocaine.
I need cocaine.
No, I'm sorry. When you came back and flossed,
I was just like, he's from Calgary. He said pagans from Calgary.
No, well, you can't remember it. You were only 2 years.
Maybe you heard.
But.
Hey, but guys, hold on. And to be honest, actually, I'm watching guys were speaking about, but it just has like. I do kind of question, and it's not a question. As who do you think is better, Messi or Ronaldo?
I'm a Juventus fan, but it's better Messi. I never wanted Ronaldo in my team.
And to be honest, I think Messi once upon a time was better. So he
Ronaldo.
Had, he had like higher peaks, but basically he also has lower lows. So it basically is in a way that like Messi was once upon a time better than Ronaldo.
Everybody.
But in total, like during his career, I would say maybe Ronaldo.
Everybody
Ronaldo, I agree.
A bottle of champagne in his arms. I'll leave the beer as well and don't give a fuck. As I come from the countryside.
I don't know.
Hold on. So, as a fan of Juventus, I'll tell you that. Until Ronaldo came, Juventus was winning almost nothing. Italian championship and Italian cups, okay?
He's waiting.
I don't know.
Okay, let's say it again.
I'm a fan of Juventus. Only until I die, okay?
Yes. Messi is better.
Then
always.
Not always. Not always.
No, I see Milan. So, who do you think is the best player of AC Milan?
Nowadays or in the whole story? Nowadays AC Milan is not a really good player. But in the story, AC Milan had Van Basten, had Rijkaard, had Gullit.
Had. What was the best one in the history of Milan?
Had Maldini, guys, had Maldini.
You are 23, 28 years old.
Anyway, to let you know, Messi is probably the greatest player of all the time.
What about Pelé?
Maradona, Pelé.
I will finish in only 1 minute. Any soccer player cannot be more important than the Juventus club. Okay?
Where's the hip to feel?
They always come back to you. This is the original and that one is flavored, but this one is the original.
But now so. You took really good for you. You like it so much?
Oh no.
It's okay. He's gonna pay. Don't
worry.
You're gonna pay.
Oh, whatever. Yeah, okay, don't worry. Don't go.
You can share.
Okay, take them both. Don't worry.
Take them both. I can take you.
He was going to ask you, do you want another one?
Oh, really?
No, take this is for you. Hey.
No, this one is.
Okay, he's not gonna pay this one.
Alright, that's Drobia.
That was Drobia.
Cheers.
Cheers.
It's stronger, yeah.
It's stronger. Because he was disappointed. He said, no alcohol, it was too sweet.
Přece tvoje.